Hi, I'm Dr. Todd Cooperman, and I'll be talking about magnesium supplements with you today, basically so you understand when you need them, why you might need them, how to take them, what form to look for, and some of the results that we've recently come up with by testing dietary supplements made with magnesium. So basically, to start off, who needs magnesium? Basically, everyone needs magnesium, but you can get it from your diet. Most people can get enough from foods such as whole grains, whole grain flour, seeds, beans, nuts, orange and grapefruit juice, even milk. However, many people can't absorb it well enough. People who take drugs that lower the acidity in their stomach, such as Nexium and Prilosec, people who abuse alcohol, people with diabetes or other digestive diseases can also not absorb enough magnesium. And that can be a problem because magnesium is involved in many different processes in your body, metabolism, your nervous system. And if you don't get enough, you actually increase your risk of osteoporosis and fractures. And it can also slightly increase your blood pressure. Also, having enough magnesium in your body allows you to better control your vitamin D level. And taking magnesium can help with a number of other diseases and conditions, such as menstrual pain, migraine, etc. So you can get enough magnesium from your diet. Many people don't. If you need to turn to a supplement, basically, you need about 300 to 400 milligrams per day of magnesium all around from your diet and supplement, etc. Most people do get, as I said, enough or close to that. So if you get about 100 or 200 milligrams of magnesium from a supplement, that should kind of top you off to where you need to be. You don't want to get all of your magnesium from a supplement. If you get more than 350 milligrams per day, you can have adverse effects, including a laxative effect. So keep it in the 200 range, plus or minus. There are many different forms of magnesium. And that's important because they are absorbed differently depending on the form. Two forms that I particularly like are magnesium citrate and magnesium chloride. One issue with magnesium chloride is that you don't want to get it as a pill because it absorbs water from the atmosphere. And it will basically, you'll get water droplets on your pill. It'll ruin your other pills. So if you're going to use magnesium chloride, which is a fine form to use, it is well absorbed like magnesium citrate. You want to get it as a liquid, or you want to get it as a powder that you turn into a liquid by mixing it with water. When we tested these products, what we looked for was how much magnesium was really in there. Did they meet the claim that they made? One product did not. It had about 20% less magnesium than it claimed. And in fact, just a few days after we put out this report, we were informed that it's been recalled partially, at least the lot that we tested. Another product contained a little bit more lead than we would like to see in a magnesium supplement. You'll always get a little bit of a heavy metal along with minerals. But one product exceeded the limit that we use. And it's best to avoid heavy metals like lead or cadmium, etc., when you're taking a supplement. Basically, when you're taking magnesium, be careful. Don't take it if you're also taking a carotenoid such as lutein or lycopene or beta carotene, because magnesium as well as calcium inhibit the absorption of those carotenoids. So you want to take them at different times of day. Also, if you do take magnesium, be aware, as I mentioned, it can cause diarrhea. Certain forms of magnesium, such as the hydroxide form, which is used in antacids, can also interfere with absorption of a number of drugs, including statins and antibiotics. So if you're using those forms of magnesium hydroxide, don't take it when you're taking those drugs. We have extensive information about all of these in our report, including our top pick among these products, and identifying the products that didn't pass our testing. And you can get magnesium for as little as, say, 6 cents per 200 milligrams, so you don't have to spend a lot of magnesium. And that's another thing that we factor in choosing our top pick. We want to make sure it's a quality product, you'll absorb enough, the dose is right, and the price is right. So if you have any questions about magnesium, about this our testing, you can post them where you see this video. And also, if you enjoy these videos, feel free to subscribe to them so you'll be informed as more come out, and we do put these out frequently. So again, this is Dr. Todd Cooperman with ConsumerLab.com. Thanks.